not to be. That is the question. Whether 'tis nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, or to take arms against the sea of troubles. I oppose it. Sleep to say we end the heartache and the thousand natural shocks that flesh is heir to. It is a consummation of only to be wished to die. To sleep. To sleep, perchance to dream. Aye. There's the rub! In that sleep of death, what dreams may come when we have shuffled off this mortal coil? Must give us pause. There's the respect that makes calamity for so long life. For who would bear the whips and scorns of time, the oppressor's wrong, the proud man's contumely? The pangs of despised love. Lost, laid the insolence of office and the spurns that the patient merit of the unworthy takes when he himself might his quietus make with a bare bodkin. Who would fardels bear to grunt and sweat under a weary life but that the dread of something after death? The undiscovered country from whose bourn no traveler returns. It puzzles the will. It makes us rather bear those ills we have than to fly to others we know not of. Thus conscience does make cowards of us all. Thus the native hue of resolution is sicklied or air the pale cast of thought. And enterprises of great pith and moment, with this regard their currents turn awry, and lose the name of action. Soft you now, fair Ophelia, nymph in thy orisons. Be all my sins remembered.
Good, my lord. How does your honor for this many a day?
I humbly thank you. Well.
My lord, I have remembrances of yours that I've long and long to re-deliver. I pray you now receive them.
No, not I. I never gave you aught.
My honored lord, you know right well you did, and with them words of such sweet breath composed as made the things more rich. Their perfume lost. Take these again, for to the noble mind rich gifts wax poor when givers prove unkind. There, my lord.
Are you fair? Are you honest?
What means your lordship?
That if you be honest and fair, your honesty should admit no discourse to your beauty.
Could beauty, my lord, have better commerce than with honesty?
Why, truly. For the power of beauty will sooner transform honesty from what it is into a bog than the power of honesty can transform beauty into its likeness. This was a paradox once, but the time gives it proof. I did love you once.
Indeed, you made me believe so.
You should not have believed me. For virtue cannot so inoculate our old stock, but we shall relish in it. I loved you not.
I was the more deceived.
Give thee to a memory. Why wouldst thou be a breeder of sinners? I am myself, indifferent, honest. And yet I could accuse me of such things that were better my mother had not borne me. I am proud, revengeful, ambitious, with more offenses in my back than I have thoughts to put them in, imagination to give them shape or time to act them in. What should such fellows as I do crawling between earth and heaven? We are errant knaves, all. Believe none of us. Go thy ways to a nunnery. Where's your father?
Oh, my lord.
May the doors be shut upon him, and he may play the fool nowhere but his own house.
Soldiers, scholars, eye, tongue, sword. Expectancy and those of the fair state. Class of fashion, old form. The observant of all observers, quite down. I, Ophelia's most dejected mention. Such honey for his music vows. Youth, plastic with